Hey guys, here we are back on Wind Chaser. So, in the evening, beef is still decent. What do we have for? Ooh, we have quite a bit of slaughter weight. I just started the game, so we're at 0% productivity. Big beef. Sugar beets are growing. Alfalfa is growing. Some of the threads for like the flickering, and they say like turn off your adaptive V-sync and such, and it doesn't really seem to be helping. Impossible since you can't move your body, but So we can transport 42 mature. And then we can haul back like 48 or something like that. I love how amazing this lighting, this game looks with that lighting mod. Thank you. So I put in a mod that shows fill levels based on your selection. So I think now would be a good time to give you guys a little tour, since the lighting is on our side, of recent improvements with our loaded trailer. We have new trees, first thing you will notice, dividing the fields. Also a new dirt road going back. So up here is where you can sell bales. Traffic is really congested over here. So a new island, hotel, set in more trees along the road here. And up here at Lake Country, so there's a road entrance to the hotel. That's where the radio station is, and lumberyard, same as always, but it looks terrific with this lighting. little chicken hut back there. Soybeans. Corn. Corn's growing nicely. This is all the stuff that we planted in our crop farm. You get a nice view of, good appreciation of the clip distance. Pig barns over there. Can't quite see the farm though. Anyways, over there, you guys have seen enough of that to know what's over there. See the entire dairy up on the hill now with the trees. See the entire town. Dairy farm out in the distance. See all the little details. So he's busy unloading. Sorry about the random pauses. I'm making dinner and recording this. Anyways, so that guy's done. I'm just gonna unlock the trailer there. Now they make an Animal HUD mod, PDA mod, that makes it really easy to keep track of all of your. I need that adjustable mirror mod so I can use my mirrors to actually back up. So I don't think the center of gravity is quite correct on this trailer. It's a little tippy. But you can use this to haul water and milk. I have the milk trigger at the dairy so you can manually sell your milk. I mean, you don't have to, it still sells at midnight, but. And it's not like the prices fluctuate or anything. So this should be good with water for a while. We're good with mixed rations. I guess the only thing we have left to do is check our I think we'll do another run of beef. It's because we have so much. Fast forwarded time like 2 days, I think. slowly paying off a huge loan. But I adjusted the interest rate so it wasn't so outrageous. Just so you could actually buy land and facilities, you know, take out a $2-4 million loan, and the interest won't kill you just because my growth stages are so long that, you know, the life of the loan would be one harvest, you know. So now I have it set up for a 10-year note based on 30-day years, essentially. So instead of 12 months, it's 1 month per year, so basically 10 harvests on this map to pay off your loan, if that makes sense. So hopefully you can get it done. It should be pretty easily doable, because on our crop farm, we're on our 6th season, and we probably have $4 million in land, plus equipment that we bought, so it's easily doable in 10 seasons. And it turns out that this beef farming is actually quite profitable. It's pretty easy. The prices they have on this beef now to buy is pretty relaxed, meaning it's pretty cheap, $200 to buy a calf. And I have the price multiplier, so we're getting about $800 per cow. Actually, I don't know how much a beef sells for per ton, but I feel like that's pretty reasonable. I imagine it's a little bit higher, but that's what the great demands are for. So we're always buying cows as we sell them, since we're down here, and it's cheaper to buy from the market than it is to buy from the store. So, next thing I'm going to do is get my Budweiser facilities functioning with the Universal Process Kit, and get the SemStone functioning with the Universal Process Kit, so you can bring in water, sand, and whatever else, gravel, and it will make cement that you can sell at the construction site, and then you can also sell sand at Lake Country and a few other locations in town, and beer, you can sell beer probably at the grocery store in town, at the hotel, and then I'm gonna make it so you could probably sell beef and pig at the grocery store as well. Just so there's more sell points than two. still have to add in the turkey or the chicken, whatever you want to call it, to the map. I'm going to make it a turkey farm because there isn't many chicken farms around where I live. A lot of turkey farms, though. So our alfalfa, just had to plant it once and it keeps on regrowing. I actually had to reset the fruit density file so I can make, you know, do all my map editing and stuff. Rework some fields and roads. I think we'll call it a day with hauling. And test out our new field. Sprayer. So we'll bring up our soil mod. So we have to get good yields on our alfalfa because we pretty much bale half of it and chop the rest for silage. Sugar beet, we're going to have more than enough sugar beet to get us through like the next 10 years. That's spec'd at 30 ton an acre beets. So I really just have to find the motivation to finish up that fast manufacturing sprayer tank and finish up the framing and the booms. It will go together pretty quick once I figure out how everything is designed. So this will probably be the most beautiful video I've recorded thus far. Just amazing lighting. Perfect time of day to be doing this. The clip distances the way I want them, and shadows. Just a little bit of waste, but not too shabby. Soil mod kind of takes a back seat when you're running dairy or beef. You're more concerned with where you spend most of your time once the crop is grown, mowing, winrowing, harvesting, baling, transporting, stacking, and then making mixed rations and keeping up with your livestock. But once you get all the bales off the field and stacked, and you have a pretty nice stockpile of mixed rations, you have a fair amount of time to just tend to your crops and do your soil management. Where, like, if this was a crop farm, you would just fast forward time to harvest, you know, and then check your crops, like a growth stage or two before the final stage, and spray if it needs it. Where here, if you fast forward time a couple days, you know, say 4 days, that's 4 days of everything you need to replenish your grain, your silage, your you have to clean out all the manure. You want to utilize as much liquid manure as you can, or transport it to like a staging bunker, you know, across the map. There's like 3 slurry lagoons that you can transport liquid manure to, and just stockpile it there on the edge of a field in case you need it. You know, if it turns out that you're at a point where you don't really need the liquid manure, but yeah, you don't want to waste it, so. And then you could always, if you're into, like, compost, like the compost and solid manure, you can, like, bring all your extra bales and all your extra crap to the composter over there and grind it all up, get some compost. Or you can sell all your extra bales over at the bale cell. Doesn't really pay for a straw, but for hay it does. Love this 120-foot boom. You cover so much ground so quick. And the capacity of both these. So I can go in between. So that's my saddle tanks. That's my sprayer. That's my tractor. It's empty. So I got a good idea of what's left in the tank. Works with trailers as well. Cool little mod. So, what I'm going to do during this sugar beet harvest is I'm just going to rent that Euro Tiger. And then probably, like, I'll rent a big tractor and grain cart, dump cart, oxbow dump cart. Just because I don't need to buy this stuff, because that field over there is going to be more than enough to feed our little operation. Our yields already, our productivity's already, you know, 100, over 100%. So we are done with this field, minus that little spot, but looks mighty nice. So, I will probably end the video here for you guys. So, thanks for watching.